I welcome all of you on platform of Yourpedia Education, and I'm very sure you must be relaxing nowadays after your exam. And today I have come with very important information for students who are interested in higher education, who are interested in academics, who are interested to explore their academics abroad, and those who want to do work, research work in real technical domains, projects. एंड जिनको बिना पे किए मतलब बिना पैसा खर्चे बाहर जाना है और जिनको अच्छा प्रोग्राम चाहिए तो उसके लिए दिस इज द न्यू वीडियो आई एम मेकिंग. यू सी इन इंडिया IITs के अंदर बहुत से कोलेबोरेशन वाले PhD प्रोग्राम्स हैं. जो कोलेबोरेशन का मतलब कि IITs एंड फॉरेन यूनिवर्सिटी कोलेबोरेट टुगेदर एंड प्रोवाइड यू PhD डिग्री. सो वंस यू गेट एनरोल्ड और रजिस्टर्ड इन सच PhD प्रोग्राम्स देन यू आर टू stay in India also, and during your PhD you have to go abroad also. Suppose you spend 4 years in PhD or 3.5 years in PhD, then out of that 3.5 years maybe 2.5 years you have to be in India and 1 year you have to be abroad. That is called collaboration program, and this is a total scholarship program, and in which scholarship is good, and other than scholarship there's a fee waiver, and then there's a other kind of funds are also given to you for example to go abroad for conference attend if you want to go for attending conference. ऐसा भी आपको कंटिजेंसीज वगैरह वो देते हैं. सो दिस इज ओवरऑल इज अ गुड प्रोग्राम. लाइक सो दिस माय फर्स्ट वीडियो ऑन कोलैबोरेशन PhD प्रोग्राम इज बेसिकली IIT बॉम्बे एंड मोनाश यूनिवर्सिटी. मोनाश इज ऑस्ट्रेलिया के अंदर है यूनिवर्सिटी, दैट इज इन मेलबर्न, एंड दिस इज अ रियली गुड यूनिवर्सिटी. इट्स अ वेरी गुड यूनिवर्सिटी. यू कैन सर्च ऑन इंटरनेट ऑल्सो मोनाश यूनिवर्सिटी, विल फाइंड द डिटेल्स ऑफ दैट. सो IIT बॉम्बे एंड मोनाश यूनिवर्सिटी हैज क्रिएटेड अ रिसर्च अकेडमी इन IIT बॉम्बे ओनली. So for this particular thing they have created a research academy, and that academy is situated in the campus of IIT Bombay, and they are working on some projects. So this is this scholarship for PhD is offered to almost every branch. That means engineering and science and management, all branches. If you are MSc mathematics, M.Tech mathematics, or if you are a student of physics, or your students electronic engineering, electrical engineering, civil engineering, chemical engineering, agricultural engineering, mechanical engineering, then you can apply in this. So they have projects. From seeing the projects, you can identify that. Let me give you brief and then I explain you in detail. This project is for 3.5 years. That is what they are saying. And in 3.5 years PhD, may you are to stay in India and go abroad also, that is Australia also, and minimum stay in abroad US university is 1 year. That is the meaning of it. And PhD will be offered combined from both, and the career is good. If you ask me, sir, if I get into this, should I go for that? Answer is yes. If you have interest in the project, you should go for that. Now let me tell you, those of you who have really good academic background and they are ready to study further, they have research bent of mind, only those students should apply. Can BTech student apply? Yes, BTech students with good academic background and good CGPA can apply. Can M.Tech students apply? Yes, M.Tech students can apply without GATE. GATE is not required from M.Tech, but they should have good CGPA. They have not mentioned any requirement of CGPA here, but I'm telling you which students should apply. That is because the probability will be high. See, you can apply otherwise, but probability will be high if you have really good academic background. Now, you know, let me first explain this university and tell you at the end what is the Yourpedia is going to consider the consultancy of students to apply in this. Yourpedia team is going to consider that, then that will be paid consultancy. But only those students should apply jinka academic background, minimum academic background se suit karta. I'm going to tell you that at the end, that these students should only apply the Google form which is really attached to the videos down there. Those who are interested in this and those who have this criteria and they want paid consultancy from Yourpedia, that also I will tell you, they only fill the form, not others. And this we are going to consider only for next 3 days because the last date is 16th March and it is going to take minimum 10 days for us to prepare entire groundwork for you, right? So let me now start. What is this program all about? Before I start discussing research projects, let me give you the first brief of this. So this is for PhD and application for this June 2020 inductment. You will be joining the program in June 2020. So application is open for that, and the last date for that is 16th March. So by 16th March, we have to apply for the admission in June 2020. You will start your program in IIT Bombay. So first I will be admission process is expression of interest stage. Candidate is going to fill a form in which obviously we are going to help you in that. So expression of interest is a form, and they will see your form. In that there will be a statement of purpose also, that why you want to join this, what is your background, what is your academic background. So they will see and assess your suitability for the program, right? You will also tell your research area in that. And if your EOI form is found suitable, then you proceed to next stage. Next stage is nothing but you have to fill the form A. So next stage is once you fill the form A, that is the form A number will be given to you, FAN they call it, that FAN number will be given to you. And you know, you have to basically upload certain things here, your academic transcripts which your university will give you, and your GATE score if it is required, TOEFL, GRE. As of now it is not required, but once you want to go to Australia, that is after I think 1.5 to 2 years, once you want to go there, then they will ask you to fulfill that criteria. Monash University requires TOEFL or IELTS or GRE. That is one of the criteria they will ask you to write, and that will be written at the time of visa, not immediately. As of now, it is not required. As of now, GATE is required only from BTech students who want to directly go into PhD program, not even MTech. MTech does not require GATE score. So they have some clusters of research areas, and these are those clusters they have created in IIT Bombay. So kaun-kaun si cluster areas create kiya inhone? Material science, metallurgy, nano, engineering, green chemistry, chemistry, catalyst, reaction engineering, mass, CFD, modeling, manufacturing, computer science, IT optimization. If you ask me, they have considered everything, including management. So they have made all the domains. So engineering and science students can basically apply into this. In this particular areas. So once your form is found suitable, understand, now your research area is found suitable, your academic background is found suitable, so they are going to call you for interview through mail. They are going to call you for interview, and once your interview is also done, then you are inducted in this particular program. Then you will be inducted in this particular program. Now let me discuss with you program outline hai kya? What is the various program outlines for this? You see, in this particular thing, they have mentioned that they have created some kind of research academy. You know, they have created Monash University and IIT Bombay. They have created some kind of research academy, which is located in IIT Bombay. That is Powai only. And PhD will be on an average 3.5 years. Aap maan ke chalo 4 years. In my opinion, they have not mentioned for MTech or BTech students, but maan ke chalna 4 years mein you can complete it. Obviously you will work nicely, you can complete it. Jisme minimum 1 year, aap maan ke chalna jisme minimum 1 year you are to be in Australia, that is Monash University, you are to be there. And in between also you can go to different countries also for presenting your case. So normally collaboration PhD wale program mein hota kya hai, 60% of the time you are in India and 40% of the time you are abroad. Normally aisa hota hai. And conferences where you are attending, global conferences you are attending, one of your guide will be IIT Bombay and another guide will be in Monash University, Australia. That is how this basically thing are done. And also you get a lot of grants and everything will be provided to you. So the rest, you know, hostel facilities, everything, universities may you will get it, those everything will be provided to you. And time spent in Monash University may be longer depending upon your research. So suppose your guide of Australian university says, no, you need to overstay, then you can go there. That is also one of the things which will be required for you. So your stay in Australia can be long. Okay, now I go for some kind of research projects jo aapko required hai kis area mein. How do you decide that I want to go for that? You know, they mentioned that what projects they are having, what projects in which area they are having projects. So they have mentioned already the projects which they are having, and if the student or candidate has interest in these projects, then they can apply. That is what they expect. Now suppose I go for clean engineering, let's say what are the projects they have in clean engineering, if somebody is interested in that. So they will basically mention some of the projects here. So they have name mentioned the name of the projects, supervisor's name, IIT Bombay. Suppose you want, you are interested in this computational engineering, simulation and manufacturing, infrastructure engineering, let us say you are interested in that. What you can do, you can go to Monash University and you can find out the profile of this professor, And once you go to the profile of this professor, you will understand many things, what domain he is working in. Similarly, IIT Bombay supervisor, Dipankar Chaudhary supervisor is there. So you can go to his profile also and understand more. And project title also he has given, what is to be done. And he says that yes, we need candidate for that. So what you have to do is you have to see that whether you want to work in this area and what these guys are working, and then what can be future may how I can work in this area. That is called research proposal, research statement. And these kind of collaboration projects may, that is the most important document. Let me tell you, your academic background, let's say 8.5 CGPA plus, GATE score is good. Those things are prerequisites. But the main important thing which will get you admission in these kind of prestigious scholarships programs is your research proposal only, which you need to make really by seeing what professors are working and what your academic background is. So pehle isko detail mein hume dekhna padega what we are doing, what professors are doing, clean gasification, high ash, lignites for power generation or co. Inse bahut idea nahi lagega tumhe. Title se bahut idea nahi lagega, but the moment you start seeing their work, then you will get lot of idea. So advanced computational engineering, simulation, manufacturing, nanotechnology, these are the project's names. So we get lot of idea from this. All I can tell you is they mention the projects, they mention the professors. You can refer the research work of the professors, make a really good research proposal for you and go into that direction. Anyhow, now this I think is the research areas they mentioned, in which areas they require students. That is what they have mentioned. So let's go back and find out. Okay, now I think program outline we have done. Application requirements, let me see whether I can show you something here. Application requirements, application requirements, you know what is what they require is this. Either you should be BTech with GATE score in with you, or you should be MTech without GATE score. Let me repeat, you can be BTech but then GATE score is required. Sir, very high GATE score is required? No, only valid GATE score. Obviously they will be comparing. So if you ask me that this is a PhD program, sir, what should be the criteria? I'll say your CGPA 8.5 is good. CGPA ya 80% is good, whether it is BTech or it is MTech, that is good. So those students who have this university, you know, IIT, NIT students have some advantage because it is IIT Bombay, no doubt in that. But even if you are not from IIT, NIT, other universities, and your credentials are good, your research proposal is good, your presentation is good there, you will certainly get the calls. So 80% or 8.5 CGPA BTech, and if you are BTech, then you need to have GATE. How much GATE? They have written only qualifying. In my opinion, even if you are 40, 50 GATE score you have, that is going to work. If it is MTech, then no GATE score is required. If you are MTech, then no GATE score is required, but your CGPA should be good and research proposal should be good. That is the criteria. Sir, any other criteria, any other category? Yes, there is another category, which is only BTech, no GATE, but 2 years of professional job experience. So those of you who are doing job somewhere and they have 2 years of job experience, professional job experience into some domain, jisno research area jo inhone bataya, usme agar experience hai, GATE nahi hai, lekin BTech mein CGPA achha hai tumhara, you must apply, kyunki maximum probability for you is selection. So if you have job experience in particular domain, let's say job experience mein agar aapne koi aapne research associate kahin pe lage ho, even that will be added into that. You know, RA vagara karte hain students IITs mein aur DRDO vagara mein, so that CSIR ki lab mein, so that is going to help you. So that also you can apply. I hope this is clear how you can apply. And you know, language proficiency and other things, that is as of now is not required. TOEFL GRE, that is required once you want to go abroad, that will be required for you. Now let me take you to application requirements. I think we have done research projects. I have shown you this form. I will just tell you what is required. Okay, fee structure and scholarship, that is something which you will be interested to know. So इसमें आईआईटी बॉम्बे का फी स्ट्रक्चर तो आप आईआईटी बॉम्बे की साइट पे जाके देख लोगे व्हाट इज द फीस रिक्वायर्ड एंड ऑल, दैट इज लेस देन एमटेक एंड बीटेक स्टूडेंट्स. स्कॉलरशिप यू नो दिस इज मेंशन, आई मीन फॉर फर्स्ट टू इयर्स बिकॉज इट्स अ फोर ईयर प्रोग्राम, फर्स्ट टू ईयर यू मे गेट 3,72,000 अप्रोक्सीमेटली 30,000. सो वेन यू विल बी इन आईआईटी बॉम्बे हाउ मच यू विल बी गेटिंग 30,000 स्कॉलरशिप फॉर फर्स्ट टू ईयर, एंड इफ इट इज एक्सटेंडेड टू नेक्स्ट टू ईयर देन इट इज 35,000 के आसपास यू कैन थिंक ऑफ गेटिंग. एंड वंस यू गो टू ऑस्ट्रेलिया देन यू get per annum $25,000-$26,000 per annum, so approximately $2,000 plus you get in Australia, so that also you can save money. So nutshell may you need not to pay anything from your pocket, in fact you will be saving and you will be earning during your PhD, right? The rest they have also already told you that airfare coming going, those all benefits and those advantages you are going to get it. So these are the things obviously which are not to be mentioned, this is more or less you are going to get it. This thing is something which you can get it. Now you know I had open this particular thing also, let's see. When you fill the form, no, there are certain domains, there are certain areas which they require you to fill it. When you fill the form A, then you need to mention certain things, obviously score and all they are going to write it, which are the main subjects we want to study, those things are to be filled. Then what else is to be filled is 200 words you are to write that why you should be taken as PhD student. That is something which is very crucial. I mean form AMA, these things are very very useful, and there is this is the domain where mentor of Yourpedia is going to help you. Actually this is called statement of purpose, where you have to write. So statement of purpose and research area, work experience if you have, how it is to be mentioned, how it is to be linked with your research area, that is to be done. Research publications if you have, that also you have to write. These are some of the domains, your reference, who are going to refer you, your professors or your boss in the industry. So all these things are to be mentioned in that particular form. So the moment we go to that form, I will discuss with you how it is to be filled, that we can go for it. So I think this is more or less the details of this Monash scholarship. And as I told you, there are so many collaboration wale PhD programs. We will keep on telling you how this is to be filled, and they are the good opportunities. You know, unless until you apply, you will not get selected. Now let me come back to the last part. How Yourpedia is going to help you in this? You know, Yourpedia consultants, consultancy is a paid consultancy for these things. And for this now, I request only those students who are interested in this, and those students who have CGPA more than 8, only they apply, because less CGPA ki probability of selection is less. So if your CGPA is less than 8, you please do not fill the Google form of Yourpedia. I'm not saying apply in IIT Bombay, that is your wish, but if you want to take consultancy from Yourpedia, that is a paid consultancy, and that is the Mangalyaan package. If you go to yourpedia.in, there is a package called Mangalyaan, and that is the package for MTech to PhD for these kind of courses, that only you have to take. And if you're interested in that, then you fill the form, and once you fill the form, your CGPA criteria should be 8+. If you do not have 8+ CGPA, probability of selection is less. I don't want that we give you paid consultancy but you don't get selected. That will, because you will be spending money, and it will be wasting your money also. So if your CGPA is 8, any university you are from, BTech or MTech, CGPA is 8, and MTech ke liye, as you know, it is not required, GATE is not required, but if you are BTech, then your GATE score should also be there. Preferably those students who are getting more than 40 marks in GATE and CGPA 8+, they should only seek the paid consultancy of Yourpedia by filling this Google form which we are attaching. And even if you have taken the paid consultancy of some another module of Yourpedia, then there is a you have to mention that, you have to say that you have taken some paid consultancy. So if you have already taken some paid consultancy, then you tick it that you have taken paid consultancy. We'll see how it is to be adjusted then. But those who have 8 CGPA plus and GATE score for BTech, they apply. MTech 8 CGPA plus only apply. And those who have job experience, let's say of 2 years, and they have not, don't have GATE but CGPA is 8, they can also apply for this. So fill the form, and only next 3 days we are going to accept this form, because then we are to 10 days it is going to take to complete your module and to create a domain for you. And every background student can write math, physics, everything, and your PDA team will see your profile and then only shortlist some candidates jinki probability jyada hai. To pehla screening hum hi log kar denge, pehla screening IIT Bombay ki bhi aapko jane ki requirement nahi hai, EOI wo hum hi screening kar denge on the basis of our experience whether you stand a chance or not. So the moment we screen it, we will call not everybody, whosoever will fill the form, we are not going to call everybody. We are going to call only those जिनका chance है selection का. So कुछ चीजें आपसे इसमें पूछेंगे, आपका background क्या है, आपका research area क्या है, वो आपसे पूछेंगे, and then you will fill those form, send it to us, and within 3 days we are going to tell you whether you stand a chance or not. Suppose you stand a chance, then you start doing that particular process. This is how it is to be done. I hope this entire thing is clear. This is a good scholarship. Just apply and we will keep on coming with more such particular collaboration PhD programs. Thank you.